What's shaking, people? Back with another reaction, back with some more soft cell.
Or are we? Actually, we're back with some erasure. That's right. We're going to listen to an erasure remix of a soft cell track, which Han Solo made this available to me. I didn't even know it existed, but I just reacted to Bedsitter? By Soft Cell, and so it's a really good time to listen to it. So shout out to Han Solo for making this available to me in a perfectly timely fashion. So I imagine, you know, when we say an Erasure remix, I imagine this is more Vince Clarke, in terms of, you know, he's the one who sort of works the synths and the drum machines and so on. I imagine it's mostly a Vince Clarke remix, but again, I'm fascinated. The idea of taking, you know, this sort of edgy, kind of like flying off the rails, like sort of wicked atmosphere of a soft cell tune, and then giving it the Vince Clarke erasure touch. I'm really curious to hear how it'll sound. So let's get to it. This is Bedsitter, the erasure remix from Soft Cell, originally. Oh my god. Speak to me, baseline. Like computer virus at the end of the measure.
Thank you.
here. So two things stand out to me. One, big ups to Vince. It's like he took an already amazing tune and then put his, you know, characteristic spin on it and stretched it out a bit. I love it. Number two, in regard to that, when was that composed? Do you know Han Solo? If someone does, shout it out. I'm curious if that's a more recent mix, because again, a number of you pointed out that his remix on the chorus album that I just reacted to, I'm blanking on the tune in the moment. But a number of you pointed out that's not from back when they made Chorus. That's a 2020 remix that was made, you know, in conjunction with the 2020 like deluxe edition release. Secondly, you know, Seb was mentioning that, you know, some friends of his had sort of, you know, maybe teased him about listening to Soft Cell because Mark Allman is maybe the most polished singer. Maybe he's, you know, doesn't have the like most perfect craft. But Seb was saying, you know, I don't really care. Like, he sings with such passion, and even though it's not a voice that maybe I can hear every single moment of every single day, I really love it for what it is, and I absolutely agree. Like, I just, like, one, I can feel the passion. Number two, I can feel the edginess. I can feel the, like, it's almost like he's, like, traveling outside the lines and expectations in his vocal delivery as a way to, like, you know, continue the theme of being a bit crass, a bit outside the lines, a bit, you know, unconventional. So yeah, bottom line, I love his singing too, and like, even though this is a remix where someone is taking his vocals and kind of, you know, reconfiguring them with the track that he's remixing, it really came across in this version too just how much I like his vocals. So again, shout out to Mark Allman, shout out to Seb for that point, because I really enjoyed that. And again, it's not just that people offer their opinions on the songs and the album's context, like information about the group or the making of a particular album. But I love when people offer some anecdotes and sort of personal history about the way an album or a tune sort of interacted with them at a certain time in their life and what it now means to them and so on. Luca appreciates it too, even though she's sort of half between asleep and awake. In any case, let me know what you think of this amazing remix. I will see you next time. Peace.